house? We...
It's focused in a more specific way. Have you been to the left wing of the house lately?
I guess I haven't. You can get so lost in the right wing, as I've heard people say. With the conspiracy theories and the QAnon.
Yeah.
But no,
in the
I have...
left wing of your home, not mine. I shouldn't say our
house.
Yes,
please.
Don't hurt me. I've been building a hell house, and it's got a focus. Every room is dedicated to one of the finer arts.
One of the finer arts, like theater or dance.
No, like butt fucking, oral, pumpkin fucking.
There's a whole room devoted to pumpkin fucking?
People do it every year and it's a crime. I'm trying to
Is it a crime or a sin? Because I thought hell houses were
crimes
about sins.
Crimes are sins, baby. But so you think Bill Cosby just committed a crime?
Get him in early.
Committed a crime, not a sin. When he made that jello pudding so good. Sinfully tasty.
I think some sins are not crimes.
Name one.
Coveting your neighbor's wife.
Okay.
Okay, I named one. And...
So you're into our neighbor's wife? We live next door to Mark Maron.
Look, she's 20. I'm into it.
Yeah, baby. Is that true?
Probably.
Oh. Okay, so coveting your neighbor's wife. So not a crime, but a sin. You wouldn't get arrested.
Though, all crimes are sins because it is a sin to break the law because you are supposed to respect the government.
This is the most you've ever taught me. Okay, so we respect the government. Got it. What's next? What's another crime that's not a sin or sin that's not a crime?
So a sin that's not a crime, I would imagine, well, what are the biggies? We got murder. That's a crime. Lying to your parents. Right, because it's a sin not to respect your mother and father.
It is? That's one of the seven deadlies?
I don't know that it's a seven deadly. I think those are gluttony, and that's not a crime.
You should have seen what I did to that lasagna.
Are you just reciting your favorite Garfield comics right now?
Yes. Do you want to hear my favorite one?
All right, yeah.
Okay, so it
Do
starts...
Do it in all the panels.
I will. So it starts with the panel where it says Garfield, and then the guy...
So this is one of the Sunday editions?
Yeah, and then the guy...
So there will be more panels. There will be seven or eight panels to this?
Sure, yeah. And the guy who wrote its name, and then it's...
Jim Davis.
Right. And then it's in that font...
The Garfield font, yes.
Cartoon font.
Garfield popularized it, but yes.
In Word, it's called Joker. They won't let me write with Joker font.
Are you high right
they
now?
They won't let me write with Joker
on?
Font at school anymore.
They won't. Well,
they
the
think
Joker,
I'm a threat.
The Joker movie is very scary.
I know. I hope to see it one day. But anyways, okay, so then it says the name Garfield and then the name of the guy and then it says the lasagna episode.
He doesn't title the strips every day.
And then in the Sundays he does.
Okay.
So remember them.
The lasagna episode. So out of all the Garfields, this is the one that pertains to lasagna.
This is the lasagna episode.
Got it.
So then Garfield, in the first panel, he's in his kitty litter bed.
Has he ever been in kitty litter before?
He sleeps in a box with a blanket over him.
I guess. Have we ever seen the kitty litter, though?
No, maybe but they don't presuming. Show us where he shits because it's rude. But we assume it's also the bed he sleeps in. Because that's my understanding of how you go through life from what I've learned. So he gets up and he's like, what day?
Is this panel two?
No. Panel one moves. And he goes, he lifts his eye out and he's like, what day is it?
He lifts his eye up? So he's not wearing a sleep mask.
He's so tired.
He has to physically
pull
his eyelid
up. He's going like this.
I see.
And then the next one is a calendar zoomed in, and it says Monday.
Does it literally zoom in, or is it a close-up on a calendar?
It starts from outer space. And then it zooms in, and then it's Monday. And you know that. And then it only says Monday. It doesn't say the date. He doesn't care about that kind of stuff. He just cares about what day it is because he hates Monday.
So is it a page-a-day calendar, and it's just the day of the week?
Yeah. No, it's written like a graph, like 30 days, but every day is just written Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and no days or months. Got it?
Got it.
Okay, third frame. John comes home, and he's like, the oven's burning.
Okay, so panel one, just to reiterate. Garfield's sleeping, but then gets up, pulls his eye open. Yeah. Says, what day is it? Zoom in from space. It's Monday.
This is good.
John comes in and says the oven's burning.
But he winds it.
But he, okay, sorry.
He winds the oven is burning.
Okay.
And then Odie's like thought bubble. It wasn't me. Quote Shaggy. And then Nermal comes in to that frame. And she's like, now it's stuck in my head. And then next frame is a flip book that Garfield's looking at of the Flintstones.
Okay. Doing, what are they doing in the flip book? Some
they work
physical
at an
activity?
Office. It's not normal.
It's so they're like just sitting
it's like
at a
the
rock
Flintstones
desk?
With Dilbert.
That's a crossover I'd like to see.
Yeah. That's what Jim Davis thought. And then Garfield's like done with work for the day because that was his job.
Garfield's flipping through the flip book and that's his job?
Jim wants the backstory is Jim wants all the
Did they explain the backstory? Or we're just supposed to know this?
If you go to the back page of the newspaper, it tells you what the meaning is. So Jim has a paranoia about flipbooks that he won't look at them unless they're really worn in because he's afraid he'll miss a page and then you won't understand. So Garfield's job is to make it really worn.
Got it.
And then, how many is that?
I don't know.
Six.
Let's count them down. We have...
Okay, start over.
We have, of course, the title.
Yeah, I was going to say, were you counting
that? No, we have Garfield by title. Jim Davis. That's one.
Yeah.
Then we have the title, The Lasagna Incident.
Episode.
Episode, sorry.
Or the one about the lasagna.
The one with the lasagna.
About the lasagna.
Okay.
Yeah.
Number three is Garfield sleeping, then waking up, lifting up his eye, saying, what day is it?
Yep.
Number four is zoom in from space on the calendar. It's Monday.
Yeah.
Number five is John coming in and whining.
The oven's burning.
And then Odie is number six saying, it wasn't me. He thinks it, quote, Shaggy.
Nermal says, now it's stuck in my head.
That's number seven.
No, same one. She walks into it.
She walks into it.
Yeah. Number
so
seven.
So does Odie's thought bubble disappear and Nermal's takes over?
It's like, you know how comics are where like one's big and one's small? You kind of know what order you're supposed to read it.
Got it.
So it's like that.
All right, so we're at six.
And then, yeah, so her bubble's floating before she comes in.
Okay. And then what was seven? Seven was... I'm getting lost in this.
Seven was the flip book.
The flip book, yeah.
And then
he's
like,
going through the flip book.
Now I'm done with work.
That's eight? Now I'm done with work?
Yes.
Okay.
And then he goes back to bed and he gets in the bed.
He goes back to bed in panel nine or...
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He puts on his nightcap, his candle. He gets back in bed and then he wakes up and goes, the oven's burning, my lasagna. And then the fire department comes and they separate the family.
That's the fire department's job?
Because it's unsafe living conditions for Garfield because John burns ovens all the time.
So something wasn't burning in the oven. The literal oven was burning? Is that?
There was lasagna burning in there, but he says it like the oven's burning. So he talks. Anyway, they got separated. It's so scary.
Was that the last Garfield? It seems to be like it would be... it wouldn't be the lasagna episode. It would be the episode where we our entire family was separated.
Jim Davis has an irreverent sense of humor.
Oh, okay. You don't need to tell me about Jim Davis.
So he calls it the lasagna
episode. The lasagna episode.
But it's okay. Kind of tongue-in-cheek.
And where did you read this?
The Sunday paper. The L.A. Times. In 1984. You know how you hoard all of them in the bathroom? You could barely open the door. You almost broke the toilet with the whole stack on top. Well, your old papers. You want to mark every week you've been alive? You know how you always scream that while you're falling asleep? You're ill, my man.
You don't need to air our dirty laundry here.
You need to air our dirty laundry. It stinks. And you make me clean your gym shorts with rubbing alcohol. You said spit's the best way to get human stuff out of stuff.
That's a good quote. That might be a shirt. Human stuff out of stuff.
Yeah. Well, anyways, what I really wanted to ask you in front of everyone here was what I can be for Halloween, because you put those rules on my costume.
Yeah, okay. So the rules were...
No masks, because they scare you.
Yeah.
No wigs, because you're jealous.
After the amount of hair, or...
Everything. No unibrows, because it reminds you of your ex. No tail, because it reminds you of your past. I used to have one.
Mm.
As we all did.
We're talking in the evolutionary.
Tail, yeah. No braids, because it makes you have a weird itch when you see a braid. It's like you tried to go on that show, My Strange Problem.
Well, it's like tryptophobia when people with the new iPhone seeing the three things.
Yeah, three eyes.
It just sets me off.
Yeah, it sets you off. And so those were the main rules. And then no characters that you've heard of.
Well, I don't want to get in trouble with the copyright, enforcement.
But what are you going to do with it? You're not even letting me go outside. No one's going to see.
Well, this is for my...
I just want to parade around the house.
I don't want to have to report you to Marvel if you're doing an unauthorized Iron Man.
So what do you want me to be, since it's a show for you? Come on.
Well, no braids, so you can't be a Native American.
I wouldn't be that anyway.
We don't want you to be canceled.
I would never. I'm going to be renewed every season.
Like 60 Minutes.
Yeah.
You want to be the 60 Minutes of people.
That's the best theme song. Anyone can sing it.
No masks, so
no masks.
You can't be from 30 Shades of Grey. Or what is it called?
I think there are 50, my man.
I am severely undercounting those shades of grey.
No masks.
How do you know, by the way?
I did get a chance to read that book.
Where did you read that book, young lad?
You know that...
I save.
You know that little giving library that our neighbor set up?
Sure. They put 50 Shades of Grey?
They put 50 Shades, Playboy, Hustler...
Hustler?
Bush Magazine. That one's about George.
Oh, okay. HW or W?
All.
All Georges?
Any George Bush is referenced.
Really?
I think there are only two. There's probably some other guy.
Yeah, some non-president George Bushes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, I read it in there.
You actually read it at their house?
I took a page a day, so you'd never know.
But by the end, all of the pages are ripped out.
But you wouldn't know.
Oh.
It took me months to read it. So long.
How many pages was it?
Probably 300 something.
Okay.
Probably more.
Yeah.
No, probably less for America. Most people wouldn't read it if it was more than 400. You have to.
Okay,
admit.
I feel like we're getting bogged down in 50 Shades of Grey minutiae.
Okay,
at this
so
point.
I can't be out of 50 Shades of Grey when they're doing the kinky stuff, I guess.
Yeah.
Could I be the guy
what
from
guy?
50 Shades? Grey?
Oh, is that his name? Grey?
Yeah,
what
Christian.
A stupid book.
He doesn't have braids, a wig, a mask, or anything like that. He wears a suit.
Well, he is a character I've heard of.
Oh, man. Okay.
Yeah.
What
about some kind of monster or something like that?
So I have to make up my own monster?
Yeah, it can't be a monster I've heard of.
Ugh. Okay, what about...
What's scary to you?
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
So the scariest monster in the world. It's 6'4". When it wakes up, it yells. It made a paperclip noose and put it on my neck like a leash for that day you wanted to have a dog. It likes when the pants are cut out at the butt of itself, not others.
I like to so fine myself.
You like to what?
That's a river. There's a movie called So Fine that is all about a jeans company that cuts the asses out of the jeans and puts clear plastic on them, and it's very popular.
That would be bad if you farted. No mystery.
You leave a little residue there, too. It's
or it just is like a puff of air that you have to wipe.
It's like when you're injecting something and there's a bubble in the needle.
Yeah. I'm really sad about getting those injections, too.
Well,
I don't like what they're doing to my personality.
I'm sorry.
I feel like I'm having a Jekyll and Hyde moment every time you do them.
Yeah, I want you to grow up to be a nice growing boy. That's why I give you steroids every day.
I know, but my arms are getting so ripped, but they're not matching my legs.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's because I force you to ride around in a wheelchair all day at home.
That's fun.
It's like murder ball.
But anyways, what do you want me to be? I could either be you, which I guess is what your dream is.
That would be fun. Why don't we switch?
You want to be me for Halloween?
Yeah.
You're sick. You want to dress like me?
Yeah.
What are you going to wear?
Well, you know, your stereotypical, you know, dirty striped shirt that you wear every single... We've never talked about it on the actual podcast.
What I wear every day?
Yeah.
My jail outfit?
You look like you're in Paddington 2.
I wish we could dye it pink. Oh, that was the happiest day of Paddington's jail time.
Sure. His regular life, he was very happy with the family, but in jail, when
the
it was dyed
pink,
the pink day was
great.
Well,
not initially.
Yeah. That's the one movie I allow you to see.
It does give me hope, because when Paddington was in the jail and he thought his family was never coming to see him, he worried and cried, but he sent them letters saying everything was fine to take care of them. But I keep sending letters saying, please help, but I don't know if anyone's seeing him.
Well, I mean, my sister...
I know, I just write mommy on them and give them to the postman.
Really? Like Santa Claus at the North Pole, you hope it'll find her one of these
days? Those work. How come this won't?
I don't know. I don't know where she is. Where do you think she is? You've never given me any clues as to where to
you
find her.
You think I know?
Well,
I mean,
like you lived with her
you?
From age zero to middle school.
True, but I don't really take much in about what she would do, or I can't predict her.
Did she ever have like a vacation destination that she said she wanted to go to? Or...
She did have a vision board my whole life.
Really? Well,
yeah.
This is it. What was on the vision board? We can find her.
You want to know everything?
Well, depending on how much is on there. I don't want to get into a Garfield situation here.
It was drawn like a comic.
How many panels?
Seven?
All right, quickly go
through
the seven.
You know she's a good cartoonist.
I didn't know that, really?
Yes.
Oh, she always had
panel
talent
one,
when we were younger, yeah.
My vision board by Todd's mommy.
So she wastes a panel on the title. Okay.
And then the title of the vision board is That One with My Dreams.
That's not in the actual panels. That's just the title.
That's the quote title of the episode of the comic.
Please continue.
Okay. So panel one is like a pretty dress, like at a ball. And then she says, Met Gala. And then panel two is a pearl necklace. And she writes, pearl necklace. And then panel three is Hawaii landscape. And it says, be the architect of Hawaii. Panel four is Odie with a thought bubble. And he says, it wasn't me, Shaggy.
Let me guess, Nermal comes in?
Yes. Panel five, my mom goes, oops, I just mixed this up with a Garfield comic I like. Panel six, she said, leave Todd forever. And panel seven, she said, I wish Todd would be the Joker for Halloween. So, do you believe it?
I definitely believe the second to last panel.
What was that?
I want to leave Todd forever.
Fuck you!
The Joker one, I'm not too sure.
Please, can I be the Joker?
Why do you
so
want to be the Joker? It's a terrible, terrible, scary movie.
Because I've never seen it, and I just have dreams of it.
It's not frightening in the traditional sense with jump scares. It's just frightening what it says about society.
Wow. I love it. I want to be like that, with the makeup and fun. The big red lips, the juicy black eyes, the green hair and the purple outfit. So fun.
Dancing to Gary Glitter.
Yeah. Please. You'd love it. I'd perform all night. I would never stop performing for you. I swear to God.
Would you be doing like bad stand-up or like in the movie?
Sure,
or what?
I've never seen it. He does stand-up?
He does stand-up. Yeah, try to do some bad stand-up right now and we'll see exactly.
Okay, but...
Please. And stand up while you do it.
Well, all right. All right. Do you guys ever... Okay. So, do you guys ever have your uncle, all right, you guys know, you know when your uncle's, like, sleeping under his pillow because he's, feels everything's too loud no matter how quiet it gets? And when he rolls over...
I don't sleep on a pillow, though. That's
an
important distinction.
What? You're not sandwiched between a pillow, you're under a
pillow. See, when I say sleeping on a pillow, that's where your mind goes. Thank you.
Where was I? What else?
What else? Already?
No. Okay. You know when your uncle, like, spanks you after school because you did so good? And he wants you to do worse so that he looks better? And he has a complex about his family doing well, and he doesn't want them to, and he thinks that makes him look less than. Relatable?
Now you know the punchline.
So you'll never have to sleep in the closet again? Is that what it was? Did you teach me?
Yeah, I've been hypnotizing you every night, teaching you stand-up.
Oh.
I thought you would be better at it. I've been doing this ever since you were in middle school.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try another joke.
Okay.
Women always go outside, but they never come into my uncle's house.
All right, Todd. All right, that's enough. Todd, everyone!
Thank you. So can I be the Joker?
By the end of the show, we'll see if you can be the Joker.
Okay, pray for me, everyone.
Pray for Todd, everyone. All right, well, we have a wonderful guest coming on now. I mentioned he had a job, and that's
specific.
Very exciting. Yeah, but I didn't want to say what it was. Well, let's let him talk about it. He is known as the smooth criminal. Please welcome Allie Peterson.
Scott, hi. It's good to see you. Thanks for having me on the show.
My pleasure. Has it, just because it's in my head now, when people see you, do they sing I Love L.A.? Like, I love L.A. Peterson.
Yeah, do they sing that?
One person does, apparently. And it just happened.
It's great to see you, L.A. Peterson.
It's good to see you, Scott.
The smooth criminal.
The smooth criminal. L.A. Peterson. The smooth criminal.
That's right.
I bet that reminds my uncle of a dance he loves to do.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised. Here it comes. It's doing it.
Can't do it to the side.
Just seem to
That's
be
scary.
Leaning over.
Got a bad knee.
Got a bad knee.
Got a bad...
One that does make you sick?
Let's run through your story here, just very briefly.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, just the most brief version.
I feel as if we've... Scott, I'm going to say something to you.
Yeah.
I've been on your show many times, and...
Sure.
It's always a pleasure to be here, but I do feel as if you, you always want me to start at square one, just...
Let's...
Explaining who I am.
Let's elevator pitch this, let's encapsulate it down. Basically...
So I'm correct, this is what you want to do.
Just, there are people who have never heard the show before. Is that true? It's very true. Yeah, there's a gentleman right over there, and I don't want him to talk. But.
Let me ask you yes or no questions, and you can nod or shake your head so that no verbal Compliance is...
This is the opposite of an exit row on an airplane.
Exactly. I do not need a verbal confirmation. You say you've never heard of the show, is that correct? So you're not familiar with L.A. Peterson, the smooth criminal?
He said no.
All right,
no.
For this gentleman, I will.
For this gentleman, you will.
Elevator pitch, myself as a person.
Okay.
And then can you do it too, Scott?
I'd be interested in hearing that. I think we should all do it. I think
mine's
if
pretty,
you have,
I think mine's pretty
guests,
clear.
Yeah, we do. So yours is basically you...
Yeah, let's hear you tell it.
Your job, if I'm remembering correctly...
Yes, this is my business.
Business job.
I'm a small business owner.
You're a small... Yes, so it's not like you were employed at this as much as you employ yourself to do this.
Exactly.
You help people fake their own deaths...
Yes.
...when they want to get out of situations they don't want to be in,
exactly.
Such as relationships.
Sometimes... Well, there's a number of reasons why someone might want to fake their own death.
Sure. Credit...
Credit, for instance.
They want the credit for...
They want the credit for being dead.
They want the ultimate credit, that headstone.
That's right.
A big test at school.
Well, I won't do children. People seeing adult education? Absolutely. If you have a big test in your continuing education school, and you're very nervous about it, I will help you fake your own death. But kids, sorry, you're out of luck. You're just going to have to put the thermometer on the light bulb like everybody else.
Good idea.
Uh-oh. Sorry, Scott.
Oh, man. I've been keeping her away from him.
Interesting.
It doesn't even hurt anymore.
So you basically help these people fake their own deaths.
I help people fake their own deaths.
By shaving their entire bodies.
Yes. Now... I, of course, am completely hairless.
Yes.
And
the sweat just rolls off you in every direction.
It really does.
It's like an Under Armour shirt. It's just flicking onto us.
Elijah Cummings, rest in peace, from Baltimore. Strange reaction. Anyway... What were we saying?
So you're hairless.
I'm completely hairless.
You're hairless.
I'm completely hairless because I faked alopecia to get out of a long-term relationship.
Now, and remind me of who this relationship was.
This was to my college sweetheart, Carlifer.
Right.
Imagine living with him. He doesn't remember anything I've ever said. It's really.
Please tell me. Tell me the story about... This is, I love having you on the show because I love hearing about Carlifer. What?
All right, I'm gonna blaze through this. Because I've told this story a million times.
Oh, but it tickles me to no end.
Okay, very briefly.
All right.
I had a college sweetheart named Carlifer. As things got serious, we were going to be engaged. I got cold feet.
Can I interrupt you?
Yes, of course.
Did her parents try to name her cauliflower, but they didn't know how to spell it?
No. Todd, you're getting way ahead of the story. But don't worry. Your curiosity will be sated. As Carlifer and I got more serious, I tried to get out of the relationship by shaving my entire body and saying I had alopecia, thinking and severely underestimating Carlifer, that she would be turned off by this and would break up. But of course, Carlifer was a wonderful person. And she did not break up with me. And so I faked my own death and left the relationship, taking with me her favorite hoodie. Now, the story Scott wants to hear is the story of when I first met Carlifer's parents. I feel that this is negative reinforcement. Their names? Carl and Jennifer. Her name, Carlifer. A clumsy portmanteau of the two.
But do you think maybe sometimes they thought they were writing cauliflower, but they wrote Carlifer?
Sometimes.
Todd, do you mean sometimes when they were, like, ordering from Uber Eats or something and they thought
they were... No, when they were, like, making the birth certificate. They sometimes were like, is it cauliflower?
Sometimes when they were making the birth certificate, they may have been thinking, is it cauliflower?
Yeah. So you were you just repeating what I said, or were you saying yeah?
I'll let you decide.
Okay. All right.
So the night that I met Carl, Carlifer's father. Now, what you must understand is, he's a weak, sniveling worm.
Where was Jennifer?
Carlifer's mother, Jennifer, a vermouth drunk, was in the kitchen drinking her sixth bottle of vermouth of the day, ruining the dinner we were about to eat.
Ruining it how? Like cooking badly or making it fall down?
Both. She cooked it badly and she made it fall down.
Whoa.
I was in the living room with Carlifer, her father Carl, when Carl explained to me that Carlifer's name was a portmanteau of Carl and Jennifer. I opined that it was a clumsy portmanteau. I told him so. I shook his hand. I forced him to shrink before me. And he thanked me for it.
Yeah.
You're really cool.
Thanks, Todd. I think you're a pretty cool guy yourself.
Wow.
When you're old enough and you want to fake your own death, look me up.
I'll need it soon.
How old are you again?
Middle school.
That's right.
So, cut to now, you've escaped.
Smash cut to now.
You flash forward to now. You've now started your own business based upon your own experience.
Yes.
And you help people out by shaving them.
I shave their entire bodies. I give them a fake passport. I shave their entire bodies.
Personally?
Yes.
Except for one part.
The hair around their anus, that's correct. So that they may retain some sense of their original identity. Now, we used to do the passport first, the shaving second. That was a big mistake. You live and you learn.
When do you get anus hair?
That's a good question, Todd. And I'm not entirely sure of the answer. It just seems like it's always been there, but of course it hasn't been.
It's probably different for everybody.
Have you looked lately?
I look every day. I measure the growth on a chart.
So there is some?
Yeah.
Congratulations. I'm happy for you.
Thanks, but I don't... Is it? So it is good?
It's a big day in every young man's life.
Well, mine's getting this high up the wall.
How are you measuring it against the wall?
So, I'm not allowed to have school supplies.
Any school supplies.
So I don't have a ruler, but I have created a way to measure things that's like you make your own ruler where you draw dashes on your finger. And then I held it there and pulled the longest hair. And then I put it against the wall and measure like the height.
So you were able to put a dash on your finger as it was against your longest
anal
hair.
The dashes first, and then I pushed in with my thumb when the hair was done.
Sure.
And I
when it was done.
And I could see the line.
So once the hair's finished, you feel like you can get an accurate read on how long it is.
I've asked for help, but he won't. It's where he draws the line.
I don't think that's weird. I think it's actually probably a good idea.
So, I think we're all caught up. That was very quick.
I would assume so.
What are you doing in Portland, if I may ask?
Well, you know, Scott, I don't like to divulge the names of my clients, all the people that have killed them, faked their own deaths.
Whoa.
To pursue a different identity as someone else. Elijah Cummings, for example. Don't worry about him. He's fine. You didn't hear that from me, by the way.
We'll always save a seat for him.
But it...
So, like, the people, they get bald all over.
Bald all over.
B-A-O. Bow.
Bow. Bow is bae. That's what we say in my business.
So they get bow. And then they go to the world and just say, I have alopecia. And then does
some
anyone...
do.
And then does anybody have to shave them regularly to keep it up?
I'm sorry. They're on their own. I give them the tools to start a new life.
Shaving cream, razor.
That's right. A big Barbasol.
But there's no curbside shaving service that you offer.
A curbside shaving service?
Where they come to your house and you come out to the curb.
Wouldn't that shave be them. Suspicious?
I think it would, especially if it was on the curb.
And happening regularly at his house? Wouldn't it make more sense if he went to their house?
Even if I went to someplace else, if I did it on the curb, it would be very suspicious.
I'd love to see someone get shaved on the curb.
I bet you would.
Todd, I feel like we're going back to his details when we want to push forward.
First we do details, then we do what's next, right?
Yes, you're learning. Good. Okay. Todd, I hope you take over for me.
I think it's okay to ask details about the business because you never do. And
you expressly said you didn't want to go over everything.
Well, these are things we've never gone over.
Oh, really?
LA.
We've gone over these.
We've gone over the broad strokes, but we're getting into details now that I think are interesting.
Okay.
LA.
Correct me if I'm wrong.
If my uncle fakes his death.
It's LA.
LA.
LA Peterson. The smooth criminal.
LA. How am I saying it?
You were saying LA.
LA. LA, LA. Right?
No.
If my uncle fakes his death by getting shaved and then he can't do the show anymore, he said I'd just take over for him. So would I have to be him? And do you help with people who replace the people who have died?
Well, when someone fakes their own death, usually we don't then find someone to be that person that they were.
It's not like a Doctor Who situation.
No, because we've faked their death. So the idea is that the person doesn't exist anymore.
But what if
their life?
But what if their job still has to get done?
They should have thought about that before they came to L.A. Peterson, the smooth criminal.
You're saying L.A.
I'm saying L.A. Peterson, the smooth criminal.
It would be cool if every human being was like Spider-Man, where we're like...
That would be cool.
Who's the new Elijah Cummings?
Oh.
When you could shoot it out of your hands?
Do you hear Ving Rhames is the new Elijah Cummings?
I was as confused at that reaction as I was about your statement.
So,
what am I doing in Portland, you ask? Now, usually I have to be very secretive because of my job. My job is very secretive. I help people fake their own deaths. We've been over this.
I can't hear you. Your voice is so low.
Can we turn up me and the monitors for Tom?
You should talk in a higher timbre.
I wish that I could, but I have a... problem with my vocal cords.
They're bass.
They don't go all the way up.
Did you ever have that surgery that they do with dogs to silence dogs, where they shove a thing down their throat?
Oh, I'm a person. Have you had many dog surgeries?
Just the one that's important.
Is that why you've been wearing that cone?
Around my penis?
To make it look big.
Who are you, Marilyn Manson? All right, lots going on.
He only takes me to the vet instead of the doctor.
A doctor's too expensive.
If I have a cough, I have to pretend I'm a dog.
How's that usually go? Do you put on a costume of some sort?
I just say that he's a hairless dog.
But I get on all fours.
I mean, yeah, one that's about this big off the floor.
I have pubes, too, and hair on my head. Of my penis.
All right.
And I need help. It's weird. Help me. It gets very matted. I'm sick.
I think you actually might be.
So you're in Portland. Usually you have to keep it secret, but now you don't have to keep it secret.
I have a very special client. This is someone who's, let's say, reclusive, who invites more attention than he's comfortable with, and he'd like to do something about that by changing his look and maybe starting over somewhere else.
Okay, can you say who this client
is? Well, of course I can, but it's a very, very well-known resident of the area. Someone who's very hirsute.
Cool.
Bigfoot?
No. Oh, now, that was your words, not mine. Anyways.
You've taken on Bigfoot as a
Scott,
client.
Please.
But here's the thing, though. Like, he's already questionable whether he's real or not.
Oh, believe me. We talked about this. Not that we talked about this. I'm not confirming that my client is who you say my client is.
But hypothetically, if you were to have Bigfoot as a client...
If I were to have... You're saying, if I did it, here's how I would have done it?
Yes.
Yeah.
If I had spoken with Bigfoot, here's what I would have said. People are already having a hard time... Hello, child.
People are already... Oh, no!
Uh-oh.
I thought a very small baseball player was here, but then no, it's this child.
Oops.
Playing for the O's.
If I were to... It stands for Oregon, I believe. If I were to speak to Bigfoot, I would say to him, look, people are already having a hard time tracking you down. There's only the blurriest of photos. I think you're doing pretty good. And then perhaps Bigfoot would have said to me, it's still too much. I like my privacy. And I don't like being hounded by these people that are trying to catch me.
But L.A., don't you think like it might be scarier if you saw a gigantic naked man with no hair?
If I were continuing my conversation with Bigfoot, I absolutely would have brought that up.
Yeah.
But if you were continuing that conversation, what would Bigfoot's rejoinder have been?
Bigfoot would have said, had I been speaking with Bigfoot, which of course I have not confirmed that I have been, he would have said, let me tell you something. The moment people even get a glimpse of a naked person my size, they look away. It's scary to see.
What's he most like in terms of species?
What would he most be like if I knew him and he were real?
Yeah.
Like a big ape.
But human proportions?
Yes, like someone in an ape costume.
Like Harry and the Hendersons?
Yes, exactly.
Shaved nude?
Yes, exactly.
How many square feet is his butt?
How many square feet is it? Well, he's not known for being very wide. More very tall.
So it's maybe 2x1?
Sure, if you like. I'll admit, I'm not good with square footage. Mm. Here are the things I'm not good with. Square footage. Knowing how much it is when someone tells me how much a baby weighs.
Could be anything. Yeah, I hear like...
Well, someone says, oh, he was 9 pounds, and I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Do I make a face like, that's big, or do I say, oh, that's normal, or do I say, is he okay?
We don't know.
I don't know how much is a baby supposed to weigh?
10-ish? I don't know.
10's fat for a baby.
10's fat?
Mm-hmm.
You think it's because of fat and not height?
Is it necessarily fat or tall? What if you had a very tall baby?
Lanky.
I was 10 pounds when I was born.
Mm. And how tall were you?
I was 5'2".
That's a tall baby.
Yeah. But you should have said, are you okay?
I think we've established you're very unwell.
Well, the, L.A., this is incredible. I mean, the Sasquatch himself.
I mean, it would be.
Sure. Does it, would he like to be called Sasquatch, or is that some sort of...
Why would he like to be called Sasquatch?
How would you say it, a person not from Chicago?
Sasquatch! Sasquatch?
Yeah, I like to split the difference. I say Sasquatch.
Yeah. Sasquatch. Is that a slur to him, or...?
No, it's not a slur. I think between the two, he would prefer Sasquatch to Bigfoot.
What's his real name?
It's... It's Evelyn.
Well, maybe if we all said we had an Evelyn sighting, he would feel better and be more open to staying who he is.
I think he'd hate that even more because that's his true self.
Oh.
Why is...
People to know.
Why are they... I don't want to assign a gender to them. Why are they so reclusive in the first place?
Sasquatch, Evelyn. If I were to know why he's so reclusive, is because he... He thinks his voice is funny.
Wow.
Funny voice, really.
Like, what's it funny like? Voice. Like Seinfeld?
Yeah, could you do a... Is he like, what's the deal with these feet?
Higher.
Higher than Seinfeld.
He sounds like an extremely high-pitched Seinfeld.
What's the deal with these feet?
You Sasquatch you?
That was me. No. That was me. LA.
You scared me.
So he has just an annoying, grating voice.
He doesn't like his voice.
Wow.
No, who does, though? No, people don't like it.
I mean, you do.
I very much like my voice. But a lot of people don't, so I'm told. A lot of people ask me when they, you know, they go for the procedure to have their death faked. They say, can you do anything about my voice? And I say, that's on you. You've got to come up with your own voice.
It's a procedure when you shave them?
People are more comfortable with the term procedure than now's the part where I shave you. I say, let's do, it's time for the procedure. People prefer that too. There's another lesson learned the hard way.
Well, this is incredible, LA. I mean, what a superstar.
It would be if it were true.
If it were true. What a superstar client if that were to be the case. And yet, unfortunately, you will toil away in obscurity if it is the case, because...
If I'm doing my job right.
Does he want to then get a new passport?
He wants to get a new passport.
One that...
Allows him to travel from place to place?
Sure.
He does not currently have a passport. Mm. So this would be a new one, yes.
Okay. The first of many, perhaps.
You do have to renew them.
Every 10 years.
How old is he?
You mean, how old do I think he is, if I think he's real?
Yeah.
He's 500 years old.
So you think he's going to get so much older, he'll need many more passports? He's probably going to die soon.
He's 500 years old. That implies he's going to be living a long time. Not that he's
really
close to death.
Let me ask you this. Kirk Douglas, he's 102 years old.
You think he's going to live long now because he's 102? Kirk Douglas?
No, I'm asking questions here.
Oh. Okay.
How old do you think Michael Douglas will live to be if Kirk Douglas is presently 102 and still not dead?
Are they on a train going any miles per hour?
Yes. They're going on a train to Chicago, going 65 miles per hour. Now there's
And
someone,
how many years do they age a year?
They age 1 year per year.
Okay.
Now, they're approaching a car that is stalled out on the train tracks.
Oh, no.
The car is filled with a family of four.
No!
Mom, dad, two little kids. But they're cannibals. So...
They should be killed?
Should they?
So it's a moral question?
Because in the trunk is a missionary who delivers food to African children.
Are any
dead?
Alive. Or is she only alive as long as she's in the trunk? And if you open the trunk, she's dead.
Can I ask
Al?
Are any of the...
We're on the verge of a breakthrough here, Scott. Okay.
Michael Douglas will be 109.
Incorrect. Scott, your question.
What?
The cannibal?
Yes.
Is she a woman?
You've cracked it.
Thank you.
It was a riddle?
Yes, the family of cannibals was a woman.
Wow. All right, L.A. Peterson, everyone. Amazing.
The smooth criminal.
The smooth criminal. Everyone's took off. All right, well, we have an exciting surprise here. I mentioned this earlier. Our next guest has had several jobs. He's had several jobs. Please welcome to the stage, self-proclaimed fan favorite, Rudi North. Rudi!
What's up, Scott? Now, first of all, Scott, I'm coming in hot as hell.
That's the way they like it here in Portland.
Y'all like it piping hot in Portland? Yeah! I'm keeping it weird, too. Now...
Isn't that Austin?
Well, they do it... we don't gotta get into that.
Okay.
We do not have time to get into the weird... The one city hates... It's complicated, Scott.
Okay. Yeah, we don't have time for it because
you're too hot. We don't have time for it. I'm coming in hot, but let's get this out of the way right now.
Okay.
Previously on Comedy Bang Bang... I'm a dirtbag. I used to have magical powers, but I did have to go to hell and become the devil. And in order to return to Earth, I had to make a deal to relinquish all my powers. So now, I'm just a normal guy.
Weren't you Santa Claus briefly?
I was Santa Claus briefly. That might have been the briefest stint, because Santa Claus took that shit right back. Santa Claus was...
You also sold Christmas trees.
I sold Christmas trees. I was the owner of a donut shop, of course.
Right, owner of a donut shop.
Yeah, of course.
Yes.
But, I'm just glad to be here in Portland, and I'm good to see you, Scott. Of course, you're my
great
best friend.
Great to see
friend.
You. Yeah, well, of course, we spent all that time in the
Speed Force
together.
Speed Force Thanksgiving.
You went to Speed Force Thanksgiving.
Yes. How many of you guys know what's happening right now? This dude in the front row is like, what the fuck is going on?
Arms folded is always a good sign.
That's always a good sign. It's almost as if that previously on didn't clear up anything at all. Anyway, Scott, yeah. I'm here because, well, Scott and Brett, I hope you're ready.
Brett has Engineer some sort Brett. Of role in this?
Scott.
Yes.
I got a new job.
Whoa!
Hit it, Brett! You're gonna have to crank it. Ladies and gentlemen, get up out of your seats!
Yeah.
Get out your seats!
Yeah.
That's right, everybody, I got a new job! I got a new job, and I gotta make cash. Gotta make some money somehow, but I don't have the powers of the Flash. I got a new job. And you know it's a crime. Got a long backstory, but we definitely don't got time. All this shit is canon. This you know is true. I don't have my powers and I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Thanks, Red, cut it.
Now so that surely cleared things up for you.
Arms unfolded.
Seems like you just reiterated what you had previously spoken.
Yeah.
But I'm happy you're in.
I wonder if it was worth it at all, Scott.
Oh, no, worth it. Definitely worth it.
Was it worth it?
All right.
That was the first concert I've ever been to.
Oh, really, Todd? Was it good?
I loved it.
Would you buy a t-shirt if I was selling one?
Yeah, what does it say?
It says, that's canon.
And it has, like...
It's a canon.
The ACDC canon from Those About to Rock, We Salute
You. Of course, and I'm inside of it, and outside, I'm throat punching to the sky.
You're being fired out of it,
I'm being fired out of it, of course.
Is it a GIF?
It is a GIF shirt.
What was that sound?
Yeah, what was that?
There's someone here.
Some
like
crazy shit just happened in here.
This is like haunted house shit.
I'm fucking scared. It's like a hell house in this motherfucker.
A Christian hell house?
A Christian hell house, of course.
You should come to my hell house. I'm setting up at my house.
Really? You know, I used to work in hell.
Oh, well, then you could be a great expert.
Yeah. I used to live in a house.
So put our shit together.
Where do you live?
I live here and there.
Oh, no, that ain't good.
Oh, no.
We don't have time for this.
We don't have time for that.
But it is canon.
It is canon.
It is canon that I do live here and there.
Rudy, what's your new job?
Oh, well, of course, I did sing a big song setting up that I had a new job. So, of course, I thought of what that job was going to be.
Yo.
No, of course I did. Guys, I'm a Hollywood stuntman.
You're a Hollywood stuntman.
That's
now?
My new job, Scott.
Amazing.
That's my new job.
What show are you on?
Well, I'm on Succession.
So, did you do like the stunt where the old man peed onto the rug?
Yep. They were like, "All right, we need somebody to come in here and be disoriented and pee on a rug." And I was like, "Shit, I could do that."
I do recall there being an off-screen stunt in one episode where someone smashed their face at the bottom of a pool.
Yes, that did happen.
But we did not see that happen.
You didn't see that. I was not hired for that stunt. My stunts are mostly pee-related. I do a lot of peeing stunts.
And what about in that movie Dumb and Dumber when the cop drinks the piss? Is that you?
Did I put on a Harlan Williams costume and swish some piss around in my mouth?
And go back in time.
And go back in time? I don't have that power anymore, honey.
Yeah. So
I
sorry.
Ain't the Flash no more. I wish I could go back in time and do all the piss-related stunts in Hollywood history. Could you imagine?
Probably starting in the 80s.
You'd start right in the 80s.
So obviously previous stunts that we've seen...
Exactly.
...that are piss-related, you haven't done. But so
right.
What are the current piss-related stunts you're doing?
Well, I'm still riding off the residuals from my Succession piss. And...
A lot of residuals for stuntmen.
A lot of residuals. And also, they're remaking 40-Year-Old Virgin.
They are,
they
really?
They are, and I'm just doing the
How
part...
How old is he now?
He's 60.
Really?
Yeah, it's 60-year-old guy who's had sex a couple times. Not a good movie, but I'll take the word.
So this is a sequel.
This is a sequel. So they wanted to do a...
Is it in the Virginverse?
It's in the Virginverse.
Okay.
Of course, with the virgin suicides and 40-year-old virgin. So, of course, I sit on a toilet and I have an erection and I pee in my own mouth. This is the classic piss man stunt.
So this is sort of a Gus Van Sant shot for shot remake.
Exactly.
But this time you sit.
This time I sit. So they're doing shot for shot. But they change it up some of the shots.
Sure, yeah. Well, in the Psycho, Gus Van Sant, Vince Vaughn masturbates.
Yes,
and I don't believe Tony Perkins
did. Exactly that. Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, classically. Mm-hmm.
So now, traditionally, you've always obtained your jobs by...
Well, punching somebody in the throat. And then my powers would, of course, life swap us. I'd take his life.
Right. But it sounds to me like this time someone said, hey, we need someone to do this. And you said, I could do that.
Here's what happened, Scott. I was doing the Universal Lot Tour.
Okay.
And I don't know if any of you guys have been on this tour, if you've been to Los Angeles.
At Universal Studios, there's a tram that takes you around to different studios and shows you how to do stunts and things like that.
And there's a Jaws part.
Sure. The shark from Jaws, Bruce.
Bruce!
Bruce!
Anyways, so I
did ELO and you did Springsteen.
Okay, we did two different things. Anyways, I'm a Springsteen guy.
I'm an ELO guy.
Come on,
but
man.
But we still got along.
We love
Speed
each other. Let's
call
the whole thing off.
All right.
We drive up to Bruce, the Jaws exhibit in the tram lot tour, and Bruce jumps out the water.
You go straight out of the water? Like
out
a flying fish?
Well, it kind of comes out and like does a quick like jab at the thing that you're driving at, and you know what? I threw myself in his mouth.
Really? Intentionally?
I was like, this might be a job opportunity. So I threw myself in his mouth, got chewed up by a mechanical shark. And of course, instead of suing Universal, they allowed me to be a pissed up man.
Can I say, that's chaos.
That is chaos. It's also canon. Now, do you know, Scott, now that I work in Hollywood...
Sure.
Of course, I had to get representation, Scott.
Oh, really? You have a team?
I do have a team. I'm, of course, repped by Sprague the Whisperer.
Oh, great. Previous guest on
on the show.
Didn't realize you knew him.
I do know him. He's really great. He might even be backstage right now if you want to talk to him. But he's probably not.
Now I don't know what to do.
Yeah, I don't either.
Maybe later. It's...
Sprague, you want to come out and talk to these people?
There is a second show that I understand is not sold out.
Oh, yeah, maybe I'll do it then. You know what? Fuck that. Y'all don't get to see him. Anyway, so I'm repped now.
And you're ripped, too.
And
the stunt work is really done.
I do a lot. I hit the gym, Scott.
Yeah. Oh,
I got to work now.
Yeah. Well, before you would just take over someone's job and life.
Yeah. Before I had the powers of the Flash. So I'd go into the gym, 1 second, workout done. Yeah. It was crazy.
But I mean, you are, and this is how the Flash powers work, as far as I know.
Mm-hmm.
You are working as hard as we all work.
Uh-huh.
It just, you're doing it faster.
Exactly.
So it hurts as much as it all hurts us.
It hurts.
Right.
It actually hurts more.
In the Flash Force?
Mm-hmm. Because it's like I'm doing the entire exercise in 1 second. You know what I mean?
Right.
So when I leave, I basically collapse to the ground for a couple days.
And so the Flash can do everything quickly, not just run.
He can read fast. Now, that is canon.
That is, yeah. They call it speed reading.
Speed reading, which is pretty clever, I
guess.
I mean,
I've heard of speed reading. I didn't.
He retains all the knowledge, too.
Mm-hmm,
right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And he also heals fast.
Oh, that's good.
I think he also has sex fast.
That's a problem.
It is. I will say, of all the powers I had, the Flash power really fucked me up in the bedroom. Because in order to please a woman, I'm finding, or a man, not actually not true. In order to please a woman, you actually have to take your time.
Yes.
And you have to connect.
Yes.
What if you found a woman who had Flash powers too, and then you both were like, oh, and then you were done?
Well, that did happen one time.
One time? Really?
One time.
I was going to say it too, but then I didn't.
You found a woman with Flash powers.
I did. And we had sex. And within a minute, she had been pregnant and given birth.
What?
Wow.
That's amazing.
Canon. When you have the Flash powers as a woman, the gestation period is 1 minute.
1 minute. So you have a child.
You have a child.
I do have a child, Scott, but we don't speak of this child.
Why not?
She's my mortal enemy, Scott.
Oh, dear.
Her name is Rudi North.
Oh, I met Rudi North.
Did you?
I did, yes.
When?
On the 10th anniversary show in May.
What did she say?
I can't remember. I know it was very important to some people, but for me...
It's almost pivotal.
The minute it ended, I forgot.
You forgot. It's not laden with Easter eggs that you need to remember
later
on?
Oh, no, I sure was, but...
Possibly Pop-Tart's an important part of it?
Don't recall it all. Well, look, when you do a 10-hour episode, some things are going to slip through the cracks.
You kept wanting to leave, and then people were like, no, we got more shit to do.
Yeah.
Hey, so, I don't want to derail things, but the Flash can walk, right?
He doesn't have to do everything quickly.
So it takes so much out of the Flash to walk.
I see.
Do you understand? You have to, it's almost...
Is the Flash restraining himself from being fast all the time? Oh, interesting.
It's like edging.
Edging is... never mind.
No. I was going to let you explain, because you're the expert.
That absolutely does not need to be explained in this particular room right now.
Yeah, it definitely should be.
Well, congratulations, Rudi.
Thank
this
you,
is
Scott.
Incredible.
But I'm pissed, because I don't really want to work.
You're pissed?
Yeah.
I mean, that's good for your job.
It is good for my job, but I'm already bored of this. I want a new job.
Well,
Hit it.
Hit it.
No, no, please.
No, no, don't hit it. Don't hit it.
Don't hit it.
Don't
hit it.
Don't
this is the only
it.
Show where we ask, don't hit it.
Brett, don't hit it. Yeah, I want a new job, Scott, and now if in order to do that, I have to apply for a job and then wait to be interviewed and then be good at it.
This is losing the Speed Force powers. Everything must feel like it's in slow motion for you.
Yeah, this show's been going on a real long time.
Yeah.
Oh, Scott, well, I'm glad to be here in Portland. I'm on my vacation, so.
Are you wrapping it up?
Yeah.
All right, Rudi North, everyone. Yes, Rudi, very special surprise.
Wow.
We do have a big show, so I appreciate the...
Rudi, this is the point where we can walk around.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You can really explore the space.
I saw that. That looked fun. You guys are doing like a march thing. That was fun.
Oh, yes, that's right.
There we are. We march.
All right. Well, this is exciting. We have... I mentioned... I mentioned we have a writer here.
Give it up for a writer, y'all.
And the specific art form or the media? No, the types of things he writes are poems. Specifically, cowboy poems. Please welcome Dalton Wilcox.
City slickers! Goddamn city slickers! Although, to be fair, this isn't much of a city.
Oh, dang.
Shots fired right up.
No, no, that's a compliment! It's not much of a city. I'm Dalton Wilcox from the West! The real West, not this bullshit West you're living in. This is a bullshit West. I think you know it. Yes, I am the...
Sorry. Hello, Dalton. I'm just wiping off my chair.
From what?
Well, a little bit of water spilled on it, and I don't want to have a...
It wasn't water. He peed his damn pants.
Rudi
That's
North.
What happens when a city slicker sees a cowboy. A real cowboy.
Dalton, it's so great to see you. You are, of course, the poet... Oh, gosh, I always fuck this up. The poet laureate of the West, not the Old West.
What?
I sometimes say you're the poet laureate of the Old West, but you are
yes, that's
of
right.
the current West.
I'm the poet laureate of the West of all time frames. But most especially, that's right.
Present, future West?
I believe
like
so.
Like Westworld?
I don't know what you're referring to.
You gotta see it. You would love it.
I do not subscribe to any City Slickin' premium channels.
But you have basic cable?
Sure, of course I do.
You could probably get an HBO Max account then.
A what now?
All right, never mind.
That's City Slickin' on top of City Slickin'. I am the worst-selling author of the book You Must Buy Your Wife at Least as Much Jewelry as You Buy Your Horse and Other Poems and Observations, Humorous and Otherwise, from A Life on the Range. As well as the follow-up book, which is titled The Fast and the Furious Presents...
I forgot about that.
You still have to buy your wife... At least as much jewelry as you buy your horse, and even more poems and additional observations from a life still being lived on the range by Dalton Wilcox, who wrote the last book and may well write the next one if he feels like it.
Have you felt like it?
I have not felt like writing a new book.
Really?
No, because no one has yet bought either of the other two.
When you say you're the worst-selling author, has someone else sold your books better than you?
I take your meaning, but no. What I mean is no one has bought them books.
Really?
Yep.
Wow.
Can I ask a question?
Who says what?
Well, this is me, Rudi North.
Rudi North.
Hello, Rudi.
Formerly had the powers of the Flash.
It's complicated. We don't have time to get into that.
I picked up some of that.
how is your book connected to the Fastiverse?
To the Fastiverse?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, no, it's just presented by the Fast and the Furious.
Well, they presented Hobbs and Shaw.
Yes, they did.
And those were ancillary characters in the Furious-averse.
Sorry. Fastiverse is Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
That's right. It was explained to me that the Fast and Furious is presenting things now. And they're not so particular about what they present. But more than happy to present a book of cowboy poetry.
So you thought you'd get in on that?
Yeah, I figured I'd like to be presented by the Fast and the
Furious. You have no official agreement with them, though.
With the Fast and the Furious?
Correct.
No, I just put them in the title of my book, and they could try to sue me, but for what? Nobody's bought the book.
So you saw
half of nothing is nothing.
That's a good lesson, Todd.
Thank you, sir.
You're quite welcome, young boy.
What reading level are your books at?
Oh, not that bad.
Is it green, yellow, or red? Green is easy.
The entire book is black and white. I'd say a 9-year-old could tackle it.
Oh, wow.
But I wouldn't recommend it because most of the poems is about fucking.
I want to hear one.
My most famous poem is about fucking a hole in the ground.
And that's not famous because a lot of people bought that poem. It's famous
because I said it was.
Right.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Can we buy poems a la carte?
That's not a bad idea. But then do I still have the right to talk about it?
Yeah.
If I sell it to you, can I still tell people it?
I think so. I think that when authors sell any of their written works, they're still allowed to talk about them.
If I sell you one of my poems, I can still tell about that poem wherever I go.
I believe you can still tell
about
that
poem. That's a good deal for me.
And if you can't,
huh?
I'd be happy to help you fake your death.
No, thank you. I don't want to fake my death.
You want it to be real?
That's right. When I die, I want it to be the real thing.
Is that purely because you don't want to shave your entire body?
I didn't know that was part of the deal.
It is.
I'm not going to shave my... Hey, are you the guy that helped Bigfoot disappear?
I cannot talk about that right now.
We're going to talk about it. Folks, as you may know, in addition to being our nation's foremost collector and chronicler of the wit and wisdom of the West, I am also, very unfortunately, plagued by vampires.
That's, of course, canon.
You bet it is. And also mummies and werewolves and creatures from the Black Lagoon, what have you.
Man-things?
What's that?
Man-things?
Man-things?
Whatever knows fear burns at the touch.
Are you familiar with the Swamp Thing?
Hell yes.
The Man-Thing was a sort of...
Knockoff.
He was like the Hydrox of Swamp Thing.
I believe Hydrox is better than Oreo.
Now we're talking monsters.
Well, I am concerned about Swamp Things. Matter of fact, I have a new project.
You got a new project?
I got a new project. Hit it, Brett.
No, don't hit it.
Don't hit it, Brett.
Do not hit it.
Don't hit it.
Do not hit it.
But if you want to hit it, you could.
My new project is that I am traveling all around the United States slaughtering regional monsters.
Slaughtering, not just killing.
No, I slaughter them. And I tell them outright, I'm here to slaughter you.
Regional monsters. I'm trying to think of any. There's, of course, the Loch Ness Monster in Scotland.
I've killed the Loch Ness Monster.
You have?
I have, yes. I killed the Loch Ness Monster.
Have we talked about that before?
We did once before.
Yeah, okay,
and I don't want to go into too much detail because I'm not sure I remember what I told you.
What are some other regional monsters, though?
Hit it, Brett.
Oh,
no, I mean it.
Oh, really?
Brett,
please do.
Here we go. Monsters of America. This This here is a map of all the regional monsters in the United States.
Oh, my gosh.
Yep. I found this on the internet. And I've been going around slaughtering a bunch of these monsters. Let me tell you about some of the ones I got. I got the lizard man of Scape Ore Swamp, South Carolina. I have killed multiple skunk apes in southern Florida.
Ew.
I killed the Pope Lick monster in Louisville, Kentucky. You guys familiar with the Pope Lick monster?
Wow.
He put up a hell of a fight.
Do they name a new Pope Lick monster when you kill the first one?
Does the white smoke come out?
Yep.
Please tell me it's a young Pope Lick monster.
The Pope Lick monster lives underneath a trestle over the Pope Lick River, and when somebody kills a Pope Lick monster, you see the white smoke come up under the trestle, they've named a new one.
Wow.
And I'm going to kill that son of a bitch, too.
So you don't want to be nominated to be the Pope Lick monster?
Oh, I haven't even thought of that. I'd make a good Pope Lick monster.
I guess I didn't mean you. I meant in general.
You're saying a person in general? No.
Continue.
You don't
want to
be
this public
monster because I'm coming for you. I have killed the Loveland Frogman of Loveland, Ohio, and the Honey Island Swamp Monster from Louisiana, as well as Big Bird from Rio Grande Valley, Texas.
You killed Big Bird?
I killed Big Bird.
Carol Spinney?
And his whole family.
What?
And finally, Puckwudgie of Freetown Fall River, Massachusetts. And I've got a lot more to kill.
Puckwudgie looks cute.
Puckwudgie? Well, he's dead. Do you folks even know that you have a regional monster?
I'm looking here on the map.
Yep.
Number eight? Is that the one that we're looking at?
Yep, number eight.
Caddy?
You got a goddamn sea monster in your waters. Are you aware of that? How many of you people even know about Caddy the sea monster that plagued your waters? Nobody. Unbelievable! You people don't know about your monster. Well, folks, I'm going to take a boat out tomorrow, and I'm going to kill it. And it will die in obscurity, apparently.
How are you finding all of these monsters?
Well, I go to the place where they says that they're supposed to be.
On this map?
On that map.
Right.
So just the general region?
Well, sometimes it's very specific.
Yeah. There's Honey Island Swamp, Louisiana.
Yeah, I just go straight to Honey Island Swamp. And I look for the monster. In that case, the Honey Island Swamp Monster was a fella who was... He appeared to be a man fishing.
You're saying he changed his shape to appear like a person?
I guess so.
How many of these monsters are shapeshifters that shapeshift into human form?
That's a very good question, Rudy.
That is a good question. Of the ones I have killed, I would say all of them.
Okay.
And how many of these monsters have crossed you or given you guff or said an unkind word to you prior to being killed?
Every single goddamn one. For instance, that son of a bitch in the Honey Island Swamp says, "Hey, quiet down, you'll scare away the crawdads." And I says to him, "Are you the Honey Island Swamp Monster?" And he confirmed that he was.
In verbally, or?
He said, "Yes,
just
I am the Honey Island."
Through behaviors and whatnot. And saying, "Hey, what do you mean? Leave me alone. Put your gun away."
And that's the first sign. They always deny it.
A monster will always ask you to please put your gun away. Oh. Every single goddamn time.
What do you do with the bodies?
What do I do with the bodies?
Are you realizing now you should have done something with the bodies, or?
Yeah, what are you talking about? What do I do with the bodies?
Well, like, do you give them a proper burial or take them to the authorities?
That's funny, no. Never even thought of that. I typically just leave them where they're lying. I guess, though, in the case of the Puckwudgie, I dragged him into town and paraded him through the streets.
Was it a kid?
Freetown Fall River, Massachusetts.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, there they are. There we go. Whoa. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, those are the ones I've killed so far.
So it's the same map, just with the ones crossed out that you've killed.
Yeah, that's the one I sent to Brett, and I don't know why he had the other one that didn't have the X's. But anyways,
huh?
That right there will tell you which one.
If I may, at the bottom of the screen, it looks like there are several PDFs.
Are there subtle differences in each of them?
So there's one, two, three, four, five. Five pages open.
I don't know why that would be. I'll tell you, I don't know
Can
why.
Can we see each one, Brett?
Hit it, Brett.
How many of them have X's and how many don't?
Maybe you've killed more than you thought.
No, that's all. He's going to click on it.
No, same
it's
one.
It's smaller.
Different sizes.
Yeah,
okay.
A little smaller. Yep.
Can you open this up in DocuSign? Let's see.
Oh, can we sign it and date it?
Where is his mouse?
Maybe you should initial these.
I wouldn't mind seeing it as a JPEG.
Is there a movable one, like a GIF? Or?
Oh, sure.
I have a question. There's one on there that says Tessie the Lake Monster.
Yep.
Now, is that related to Nessie the Lake Monster?
Or Bessie the Lake Monster? Or Cassie the Lake Monster?
Or Chessie the Lake Monster?
Yeah, great question.
Chessie, Bessie, Cassie,
Nessie.
Yep.
You don't think
stress is
all sisters?
Well, that's how lake monsters work. Their names all rhyme.
are those the names their parents gave them, or are us?
I think them's the names they chose themselves.
Oh, progressive.
Yeah, it is. Go ahead.
No. So now, Dalton, you mentioned the Bigfoot.
I did mention the Bigfoot.
Bigfoot is on there, guys.
Bigfoot's on there. Yep. It's supposedly in California, Northern
Bipedal
California.
Bipedal humanoid, California, Oregon, and Washington.
Oh, really? So traveling all the way up the coast.
All the way up the coast.
Now, Al A. Peterson over here.
Hello.
He's not saying that he's spoken to him or is in contact or has a location.
I cannot tell you that I have spoken with the Bigfoot.
It sounds like you have, though.
But I cannot tell you that I
okay.
have.
Okay. Fine, don't tell me, but I'll just know it.
I haven't told you, and you don't know anything.
I know everything, goddammit.
You do not know this one thing, which I'm telling you, you don't know.
The whereabouts of the Bigfoot, who's now bald? I heard all that, goddammit, and it makes me mad.
I will ask you to forget that you heard those things.
I'll forget it once the Bigfoot is dead.
Well, good luck.
Thank you.
You'll never find him.
Well, I will. All I got to do is look for a bald, tall fella.
You should narrow it down more.
Narrow it down? Well, I guess he's got to have large feet.
This is bad
no
news.
No hair.
This is bad news for Vin Diesel.
And Michael Jordan.
Billy Zane should be worried.
No clothes, though, right? Does Bigfoot wear clothes now, Evelyn?
He will wear clothes.
Oh.
Well, okay.
I assume. If it were true.
Like, what, are the clothes, like, specially made? Because he's, like, 12 feet tall.
He will have to go to a big and tall shop.
Will he have a big tall shop?
Yeah.
He will have to go to a Bigfoot and tall foot shop. But not a small foot shop. Zendaya is Michi.
Got it.
Will he want to retain some of his attributes from being a Bigfoot? Will he wear, like, boots with the fur?
There is one attribute that he will be retaining that all of my customers retain.
Oh, yes, of course.
Oh, yeah, butthole.
Well, this is bad news. If you see Dalton out on the street and you're bald...
Yep.
Don't even make eye contact, I would say, because...
Well, no. If you are not the Bigfoot, then when I ask you if you're the Bigfoot, just say that you are.
So don't say, no, I'm not.
Don't
Please
say,
put that gun away.
Don't say, what are you talking about? Put your gun away. That's a dead giveaway that you're the Bigfoot. But if you're not the Bigfoot, just say, yeah, what about it?
But in both events, you will shoot them.
Well, I would shoot that person.
Yep.
Just don't do anything that makes a person think you're a Bigfoot.
How big do you think the feet would have to be in order for...
The feet of a Bigfoot?
Sure.
I imagine he's got feet regular size.
He's just bragging in order to make people think he has a huge schwanz?
I think...
Schwanz?
We say it's schwanz now?
It's the first time I've ever said it. Sounded good coming out of the mouth.
It was pretty good.
Wait, sounds better going in.
I might work that in my mouth.
All right.
Is this that kind of show?
I think this might be that kind of show.
It's getting to be. Would you like me to world premiere a new poem?
Oh, yeah! My gosh! This is not just an Oregon premiere, nor a United States premiere. Right. This is a world premiere.
The entire world has never heard this poem before.
My word.
And this is an epic poem, meaning it might be a little too long.
Do you want to stand? What do you want? Or do you want the audience to stand? What do you want?
I think if this half the audience could lie down. No, it doesn't matter. I'll stand, but you all can be comfortable.
Would you like a spotlight? Is it possible to get a spotlight? Hit it, Brett.
Sure, that.
Hit it, Brett.
Hit it, Brett.
Hit it, Brett.
That's perfect.
I wrote this poem today. This poem is called A Visit to Pittock Mansion. Well, they don't know about their monster, but they know about their old house. You know about Pittock Mansion? It's an old house. And it's open to the public, including me, and I'll wed there today. A mansion large, forbidding, old. In the summer it is hot, in the winter probably cold. Because of an outdated heating system and a lack of central air. But there's worse things by far that is probably happening there. A mansion like this, like I am describing, is just the perfect place for a ghost to be hiding. A ghost, a specter, a phantom, a spirit. Stop listening now if you're too scared to hear it. I went in there looking, knowing what I'd find. To slaughter a ghost is what I had in mind. The entryway was fine, and so was the toilet. The kitchen door howled like a ghost, so someone ought to oil it.
That's cute. That's like Jimmy Stewart, the tripping on the stair moment. Never mind. Do you know what I'm talking about?
When
you,
I know what no. you mean.
Would read poems on The Tonight Show?
Now you lost me.
Sorry.
I went room to room looking for signs of haunting, and there's a lot of rooms there, so that job is pretty daunting. But I saw nothing strange, nothing scary or dramatic until I decided it was time to check the attic. The attic's off limits, said a man in a red vest. With a pin reading volunteer pinned onto his chest. I know why you don't want me there, I said as I pulled my gun. Cause that's where you and the other ghosts live, work, and have fun. The attic, of course, that's where the ghosts of Pittock House dwell. And this here was a one of them. Just trust me, I can tell. He said, what are you talking about? Put that gun away in fear. And well, sir, as per usual, that was all I needed to hear. Three silver bullets, blam, 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 blam. Okay, I guess it was four. And the ghost of Pittock Mansion doesn't live there anymore. So you feel free to visit there if you live here or you're touring. But honestly, I would skip it. It's an old house. It's kind of boring.
Wow.
Dalton Wilcox.
Wow.
Wow.
Can I buy that?
You can buy it, but I still want to tell about it.
Yeah, how much?
$1 million.
Daddy?
Sorry, we're a little tapped out now.
Aww.
Ooh, all right.
But one question I had, so the attic is a work-live space for the ghosts?
That's right. Well, they're bound to the house, so they got to work out of the house.
And they have fun there, too.
That's where they do everything.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. Wilcox, but it seems to be, I'm gathering from context clues and that poem, that the way you dispatch all of these supernatural creatures, no matter what they are, what sort of properties they possess, it seems just shooting them gets the job done. Now, a ghost, from what I've always been led to believe, always, has no corporeal form. And it seems like bullets of any kind, silver, any sort of metal, would be wildly ineffective.
Well, you're only flaunting your ignorance.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing.
Yep.
But what if it was a man that you killed in the poem, and he wasn't a ghost? And he was a guy with a family. And well, he wanted to go home.
That would be terrible. But I assure you, young man, it was a ghost. I know that for certain.
I mean, the one way to look at it is he was either a ghost when you met him or he's a ghost now.
That's a very good point.
So,
even in your scenario, which ain't the case, where it was a man, now he's a ghost. And I'm going to go back and kill him again if I have to.
All right, that's our show, everyone. Warren Lapkus. Tompkins. Shaun Diston.